friends, it's good to be back in Ottawa. When I heard Mr. Harper wanted to reconvene Parliament on November 18th, I was so excited, I almost fell off my bicycle. All right, are there any questions?
Why did the Prime Minister wait so long before calling the new session?
Well, it'll take him that long to remove the muzzles from his MPs' mouths.
What is the top priority for the NDP?
Well, you know, that's a very good question, and I'm going to have to consult with my top advisor. Just hang on a sec. You're my top advisor. What is our top priority?
I haven't got a clue.
Mr. Layton, how come you and your advisor look the same?
It's NDP policy.
Everyone has to look like the leader.
And does this work for the party?
Well, yes, it does. But it confuses the heck out of Olivia.
Yes, you in the brown suit.
Would you consider forming a coalition with the Conservatives?
No way. Wouldn't even consider it. Never.
A word?
Yes, we'd consider it.
In the October election, the NDP's seat count soared. Why?
Well, because the NDP is more concerned with the kitchen table than the boardroom table. How am I doing?
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Okay, how would you handle the global financial crisis?
Well, that's simple. Could you repeat the question?
Look, I'll handle this one. The first thing we'd have to do is to get rid of the problem, Stephen Harper.
Well, how is Stephen Harper the problem with the financial crisis?
Well, he's a subprime minister.
If the Conservatives refused to cooperate with the NDP agenda, what would you do?
Well, we'd distract them by walking out during a parliamentary vote.
Oh, no, no, that would be immature. What we would do, if Mr. Harper stands up in Parliament, is we would take these red laser pointers and we'd point them at his chin.
At least we're not spraying his office door with orange paint.
Make a note. Well, I want to thank you all for your perceptive and insightful questions, as usual, from the National Press Gallery. But I have to go. My stretch limousine is here.